On 2nd June 1953, 25-year-old Elizabeth was crowned Elizabeth II, Queen of the British Empire. It was a most elaborate ceremony, featuring all the pomp and tradition associated with so auspicious an occasion. As with all other details for the coronation, the music received meticulous attention in the planning stages. It was then that well-known British composer Ralph Vaughan Williams suggested adding an innovation to the tradition-bound rite. What if, during the post-coronation procession, the congregation gathered in Westminster Abbey be invited to join in singing a hymn? The idea was controversial, and it was only after Elizabeth herself was taken with the suggestion and requested it be done that the matter was settled. Vaughan Williams produced an elaborate setting of this chosen hymn specifically for her coronation, calling it by the title Old Hundredth, whose history harkens back to the turbulent times of the Queen's namesake, Elizabeth I. After the untimely death of the sickly Edward VI on 6 July 1553 at age 15, and the turmoil surrounding the succession process, his half-sister Mary Tudor became queen and immediately attempted to force England back into the Roman Catholic fold. Her short reign was notorious for her seizures and executions of the Protestant leadership, earning her the nickname Bloody Mary. At least 800 of the reformers chose to flee to the European continent during her reign, the Marian Exiles as they came to be known. A significant number of them ended up in Geneva, Switzerland, where the work of reformers such as Guillaume Farel and Jean Calvin had such significant impact. The exiles were so impressed with the preaching and Christian society there that many of the practices were adopted in England once Mary was dead, Elizabeth I was queen, and the exiles had returned. The composer Louis Bourgeois had just published the 1551 edition of what was to become the Genevan Psalter, a work still in progress. This edition, known as Psalms 83 de David, incorporated 83 metrical psalms in the French language. Bourgeois provided new tunes for the most recent psalm editions, one of which is known to the English-speaking world as the Old Hundredth. As a side note, at one point, the overzealous Geneva City Council put Louis Bourgeois in jail for changing the tunes to some of the well-known metrical psalms. Calvin intervened on his behalf and secured his release, but nevertheless, the incident left him somewhat embittered. William Keith, a Scot and one of the Marian exiles, used his time in Geneva to not only help translate the Geneva Bible, but also to translate the French metrical psalms into English. He wedded this bourgeois tune to the newly translated Psalm 100, which later appeared in the 1561 Anglo-Genevan Psalter, the 1562 English Psalter, and the Scottish Psalter of 1564. It was common practice within the early Reformed churches to use only the metrical psalms during the worship service. In addition, they would not allow any musical instruments to accompany them, only the human voice. Not so with this festive version. This hymn was chosen by Vaughan Williams for the coronation chiefly because it had become so very familiar and well-loved by the British people.
Thank you. Lord.